I'm Hog, this is the Dice, and if you haven't figured it out by now, I'm a really, really big fan of urban fantasy. The Matthew Swift and Magicals Anonymous series by Kate Griffin, the Bone Street Rumba series by Daniel Jose Older, the Dresden Files, obviously. Anything where you take magic and you mix it with modern technology in the modern day, I love it. It's great. I think it's fantastic. I don't know why. It just really, really appeals to me. And it just so happens that there's a load of news about a load of urban fantasy things lately, and I wanted to talk about all of them, but none of them felt like quite enough for individual videos. So now I'm doing an urban fantasy roundup. I might do more of these if more of this comes up regularly, or, you know, all at once. Yeah, that's a better way of putting it. More urban fantasy news comes up all at once together, I'll probably do another one of these videos, but this won't be a regular thing. It's going to be an every so often thing. I'm going to start with Bright. Bright is a movie that's being released on Netflix this December. They released the trailer not that long ago, because they want us to wait nearly a whole year for the movie. Because they're pricks. I'd have preferred to not know right away, and I wouldn't have to wait so long. The movie is about two cops in Los Angeles. It's your standard cop movie. The two cops aren't quite the same. They're from very different backgrounds, and they don't really get along at first, but you know they're going to learn a lesson about friendship by the end of it. One of the cops is named Ward, and he is played by Will Smith. The other one is named Jacoby, and he's played by Joel Edgerton. Now, what's interesting about this movie is that the difference, despite the fact that one of the cops is black, the difference isn't racial, the difference is special. Joel Edgerton's character, Jacoby, is an orc. Because in the world of Bright, orcs, fairies, and elves all exist and live side by side with humans. A lot of people have been saying this looks an awful lot like a kind of prequel to Shadowrun. Now, if you don't know what Shadowrun is, imagine if The Lord of the Rings happened in The Matrix, and instead of the Council of Elrond, there was a megacorporation. And instead of Sauron, there was another megacorporation. And instead of the Fellowship of the Ring, you had a ragtag band of mercenaries. That's Shadowrun. And yeah, this does feel, Bright does feel kind of like Shadowrun, but like a few decades behind in terms of technology, because Shadowrun's technology is very futuristic. As you can probably tell from how I was waxing lyrical at the start of talking about Bright, I am very much looking forward to this movie. The trailer looks fantastic. The costume work looked really good. Makeup work looked really good. It felt like it had a kind of nice feel to it, you know, serious enough without, you know, being up its arse. Kind of like the way Logan feels. I still haven't seen Logan yet. Only, actually, not as, you know, emotionally impactful as Logan looks, but you have an idea of what I mean. Like, the DC movies, Batman v Superman, Man of Steel, they've been very serious, but also very up their own arse kind of serious. Like, taking themselves way too seriously. Whereas Logan, you know, the trailer kind of made a couple of jokes here and there, and they let you see the characters kind of relax and, you know, be a family kind of thing. And Bright feels the same kind of way in that kind of idea. There's seriousness suggested, but also, you know, some, you know, we're putting fucking elves in here, so. And it looks like they're using some horror elements as well, like that deer skull guy. Cool, I'm down for that. I love horror. That's also not obvious from my channel. And Will Smith. I think Will Smith is underrated as an actor. Like, he's made some bad decisions, like picking Wild Wild West over The Matrix. But, you know, he's actually good. Like, okay, I Am Legend wasn't a fantastic movie, but Will was good in it. He was very good in it. And Independence Day wasn't a very good movie, but Will Smith was good in it. Will Smith has just made some very, very bad decisions about what movies he's in, and I think that's kind of colored the way people see his acting, but his acting's actually pretty decent. So yeah, I'm looking forward to Bright. And moving on to the next thing. We're going to move from movies to a TV show. Or sort of a TV show, an ongoing series called Cops and Monsters. This I stumbled upon on Kickstarter because I regularly scroll through Kickstarter. I don't support things as often as I would like to support them, but I have a look through things to keep an eye on things to see where, you know, what things are successful, what things are going ahead, and what things look interesting to me. And Cops and Monsters kind of stood out to me because it's very much like Bright. It seems to be set a little bit forward in the future because there's holograms and stuff and force fields and that kind of thing. But it is made and set in Scotland, which is unusual because nearly all of this stuff is set in America. And the stuff that isn't is usually set in England. So having something in Scotland is nice. I watched the pilot episode. I'll include a link to that in the cards. I'll also include a link to the Bright trailer in the cards. The pilot was good. Like, very good. Very well done. Very professional. And the music was really good as well. So was the intro sequence. Wow, that was a pretty good intro sequence for a low-budget production. It's set in a world where vampires and werewolves have come forward and have decided to join human society, kind of like in True Blood, and it revolves around the Paranormal Investigation Team, which is a branch of the Scottish Police Force, and they deal with policing and protecting the paranormal community, the vampires, the werewolves, the zombies, that kind of thing. It's an interesting series, interesting idea. It tickles my little urban fantasy box. That sounded really gross. Sorry about that, I'm never going to use that phrase again. But it looks good. The Kickstarter is still running. They want to do a full series. I'm going to support it. I'm going to back it, even at the lowest level, if that's what I have to do. But I'm going to back it, and I think you should too. The Kickstarter link is in the cards and in the description. And lastly, we are participating in the cover reveal for the latest novel by urban fantasy author Krista Walsh. Her latest book is called Shadows in the Garden Hotel. It's part of the Invisible Entente series and will be available on the 18th of April this year. You can see the cover here. It's a pretty nice cover, very nice cover. Unusually and needed in the urban fantasy genre, it's about a female protagonist because we really don't have enough of those in urban fantasy. We need more female protagonists. Her name is Allegra Rossi, and she is a succubus, which is nice, a nice departure because it's nearly always wizards. It is nearly always wizards. Okay, they'll call themselves something like Matthew Swift is a sorcerer, and I can't remember. Oh, I was gonna say I can't remember the name of the character from the Walker papers, but her name is Joanne fucking Walker. She's a shaman, you know, like, it's wizards. Okay, there's cultural stuff around shamans, but it's human beings practicing magic. That's what urban fantasy is usually about. So it's nice to see a little departure. Let's go with a succubus, a non-human but human-passing creature. That's not a vampire. Because holy shit, am I done with vampires. I'm almost as burned out on vampires as I am on fucking zombies. So this is new urban fantasy, moving into kind of newish territory, straying from the urban fantasy norm, which is something I think we really need to encourage. So if you want to find out more, there will be links to Krista Walsh's website and social media in the description. I hope you have all enjoyed this urban fantasy roundup thing. I might do more in the future, like I said before, if, you know, the fit takes me. And don't forget that I've written urban fantasy myself. You can pick up my book, The Practitioner's Guide to Dublin, on hugandice.com. And you can listen to my audio drama podcast, The Switchboard, also on hugandice.com, also on this channel. So yeah, useful.